Hey, this is Caleb, and today I want to show you how I created this vision board that's in front of you with Pinterest and Canva and our Chrome extension, Pintoolbox. I think it's an amazing combination to create a vision board. There's often so many images on Pinterest that do inspire me in a way that I can't really explain because they're just feelings. And condensing that into a single visual representation is so powerful. So that's why we're going to be using Pintoolbox. Pintoolbox is a Chrome extension for designers and creatives that lets you download whole Pinterest boards with full-size images into a single neat folder. So I think it's a perfect combination. Downloading Pintoolbox is very simple. You just go to pintoolbox.com. You can find the link in the description. And once you're there, you just click the big Add to Chrome button, and this is going to take you to the Google Chrome Web Store, where you click Add to Chrome again, and then Add Extension. Now, there's just a few more steps that we have to follow once it's installed. This is just going to make it easy to access, which is that we click this puzzle icon, which is going to show us all the extensions we have, and then it will show that we have Pintoolbox. Then next to Pintoolbox, we click this thumbtack icon, and that pins it to our bar in Chrome. Okay, well, now we're ready to go. So the first thing that you have to do is find a board that you want to start downloading. I think any of these are good. I am going to start on this one, and we start by clicking the Pintoolbox icon. Now, the free version of Pintoolbox is limited to 15 pins, so I'm just going to quickly log into my pro account, which lets me download unlimited pins. Cool, I'm logged in, and now I just have to click extract images, then Pintoolbox is going to find the highest quality pin of each pin. And this usually takes a few seconds to a few minutes, depending on the number of pins. And in this case, not super long. Then I just click select all. And now I could, if I wanted to, download this as a PDF, which is sometimes useful. I could also download it as a zip, which is what I'm going to do now because we want individual images for Canva. And now it's going to actually download them. This part can take a few seconds to a few minutes. Again, it's really dependent on the number of pins. Since this video is already kind of long, I am going to fast forward this. So you'll see the pins download a little bit faster than usual. You'll find that this is very dependent on the number of pins that you're downloading and also the size of the pins. Some are bigger, some are smaller. Okay, done. So these were my travel inspiration pins. And now I am coming to this camcorder board, which I found. And there's a lot of non-camcorder related material on this board, but there's some very cool camcorder material. So again, I click extract images, and then this finds the highest quality pin. But this time around, we have sections, so it will find the highest quality pin for each section too. And you can see a display of exactly the number of sections, and I can select those sections. So for example, I could select no sections and then go and find a single section I like and multiple sections I like if I want to, and then I could download those. In fact, that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to download this board, maybe a couple of others, and then I'll meet you at Canva. Once you finish downloading all your boards, we're ready to go to Canva. You have a single zip file for each board, and all you have to do is select all of them like so, then double click. On Windows, you'll right click, then select unzip. Inside of these folders are the high quality images downloaded by Pintoolbox. Directly from Pinterest, they're very good images. Okay, we go to canva.com in Chrome, and now what we have to do is begin making our board. And like I was saying, I think having a single visual representation of what you want to be inspired by and what you want to manifest is the best approach. So the best place I can think of that is a wallpaper. And to do this, we need to know the size of the wallpaper we want to make. In this case, I'm making it for my MacBook. So to do that, what we want to do is open Google and search the size of the screen. Then we can go back to Canva and put this as the width and height, and we should be good to go. The next thing we need to do is upload the files we just downloaded. To do this, click File, then Import Files, then choose Files, then click the first folder. Now, after we click the folder, what we have to do is select the first file and then push Command A on the keyboard to select all. And this will be Control A on Windows, and then we click Open. And this will begin importing our files. We then do the same thing for both of the other folders we still need to upload. I'm going to fast forward and meet you back when everything has been uploaded. Okay, now it's time to actually assemble the vision board. And to do this, we just drag images that we uploaded from the left to the right. And this is very fun because there's no wrong way to do it. There are no rules. You just have to put things on the board in a way that aligns with what you think looks good. And you keep doing it until the board evokes the feeling that you want it to evoke in you. In my case, I think I'm really going for some kind of adventure feeling that is moody and cinematic. I'm not sure why that's what I want right now, but apparently that's the thing that resonated most with me when I was picking out my images. So I think I just go with it. And if you're kind of chaotic, then it's going to end up looking kind of chaotic because it's meant to look like the inside of your head to an extent. Really, all that's left to do is going to fast forward and play around. I think you'll know when you get to the point where it is evoking the feeling that you want. And it just takes a bunch of trial and error. Eventually, it gets to the point where things feel good. And then once you get to a point where things feel good, all that's left to do is set it as our wallpaper. To do that, we click Share, and then Download, and then PNG. Canva is going to start downloading the PNG now, and then after we have it downloaded, we can set it as the wallpaper, which is also very simple. What we want to do is go to the desktop on Mac, and then click Change Wallpaper. Then we'll click Add Photo, then Choose. Then we'll navigate to where our photo was downloaded. In our case, it's probably in downloads, as is mine. And we click on the image, and then we just click open, and we're done. I genuinely hope you found this useful. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll answer them.